from Jammu and Kashmir. And search operations by security forces is underway in the Macheri area of Kathua. Remember, Indian Army convoy was attacked by terrorists in the Macheri area of Kathua district in Jammu and Kashmir yesterday, where five soldiers lost their lives. So this is the big update that is coming in, that the search operation by the security forces continues in Kathua after the tragic attack by terrorists in Kathua district in Jammu and Kashmir yesterday, in which five jawans lost their lives. CNN News 18's Ishan Wani is joining us with more details on this. Ishan, give us more details about what exactly transpired yesterday and also the update on the search operations.
Good morning, Anjali. It was yesterday around 3:30 in the afternoon when heavily armed these militants opened indiscriminate fire at two army buses which were passing through this area in Kathua. This is a remote area which is off the track, and also the road is very muddy because of the rain, and there are the road is still under construction. So the vehicles were moving slow and were there on their ways when the intense gunfire took place, and the vehicles were hit as usual, what we have seen in Rajouri and Poonch. A similar strategy is to hit the driver, hit the front people who were sitting on the front, and then try to attack the vehicle. There were grenades hurled at it. There was other gunfire that was drawn from both the sides. You know, these vehicles were apart from each other. These were at two different locations. One was on the one axis of the road and another was on the other axis. Both sides were attacked, and it seems like at least four to five heavily armed militants opened indiscriminate fire at them. There was immediate attention given to those who were injured. They were shifted to the hospital, but later on five of them succumbed to their injuries, includes a JCO of the Indian Army who has now been killed in action. Five others are being treated at the hospital by the army. Most of them are out of danger. But this points out the fact that how situation has gotten grim in Jammu region, particularly in Rajouri, Poonch, Doda, Kathua, Riasi, because these places have seen the such kind of incidents take place. We have seen them happen, you know, in Rajouri and Poonch, and now it seems like they're trying to spread their wings in other districts as well and try to instigate that particular location as well. You know, top officials are monitoring the situation. We saw that soon after taking over as the army chief, you know, Lieutenant General Upendra Dwivedi, also now a general, visited the front line in Poonch and also was given a detailed summary. He is the one who is not who's well known to the area. He knows ins and outs. He knows what's happening in that part of Jammu region. He has been a Northern Army commander. But remember, this area actually falls under the Western Command, which headquarters is in Himachal. Some of these areas, including in Punjab and Himachal, is led by the Western Command. They were the men from the Western Command who were moving towards that area. They're from rising, forces. And when the gunfire took place, immediately multiple forces were deployed to the area, including the elite para commandos have been airdropped to the location to check those who are hiding in those woods, because this is a very steep mountainous area, high mountain passes, and there is every possibility that these militants might give slip to the forces. But multiple teams have been formed. They have been sent to the jungles. We have seen similar scenes unfold. This is nothing new. This is just the similar script what we have seen in other attacks, be it the attack in Riasi recently on a pilgrim bus, be the attack on the Indian Air Force bus in Rajouri, or be it an attack in Poonch on the Indian Army vehicle. Similar strategy being followed, but we have seen meetings after meetings taking place, but these tragedies have unfolded time after time again at the choice of their attack. But we have seen some success come. In Doda, three militants were actually killed. All of them were foreigners. And the weaponry that has been recovered from them was all heavy and modern gadgets, including the night thermal watching telescope, including the scopes which gives an enemy an advancement to hit the Indian Army from a very long distance. And the grenades were also thrown at these vehicles. So yes, there's a challenge for the Indian Army and the other paramilitary forces operating in Jammu, including the J&K police. They're trying to probe and trying to crack down on the entire, modules which are operational in these areas. This becomes important also because of the fact that they are highly trained militants. They are well know that the guerrilla warfare. They have when Upendra Dwivedi, the current army chief, was the Northern Army commander, he pointed out at the fact that it seems like they are well trained and they have well equipments and they have been trained in countries like Afghanistan and Pakistan. And that's why you see that forces might take some time for them to neutralize and take situation under control. Which isn't really going well is that the targeting of the forces has become frequent and the attacks on security forces have been there, which has raised concerns among the security establishment. Though the New Delhi has given a free hand to the forces to operate in these jungles and also in those areas which are very difficult, it might take some time for the forces to carry these operations in the remote areas of Rajouri, Poonch, Doda and now in Kathua as well.
And also, Ishan, these recent attacks by the terrorists and also the latest one in which a large group of terrorists attacked the convoy of army, can this also be seen as a huge intel failure?
Yes, it's difficult for the forces to generate intel. I'll tell you why. Because these areas had a militancy presence till 2005 at the maximum. And after that, most of them were declared as militancy free. There were almost no militancy related incidents or militancy presence in those areas. And that is why a lot of engagement that the forces do in regard to generating information from the human intelligence or the technical intelligence stopped coming. Because there was no need of such intelligence generation in these areas. So the minor intelligence might have been there, but yes, it stopped at one point of time or got low because there was no militancy presence. Now, since 2021, when the first attack took place and the deadly attacks took place, the army has to again re-energize and re-synergize the entire system of functioning in these areas. After India and China came face to face in Galwan in 2020, a lot of forces were moved in from Rajouri and Poonch and sent to on the line of actual control in Ladakh immediately. The first force movement took place from Rajouri and Poonch because these were peaceful areas. Only the ceasefire used to happen, violations used to happen there, and the forces were adequate in number to deal with that particular incident. But then in 2020, we saw that Pakistan and India decided to again adhere to the ceasefire, and that's when the areas were peaceful. But then again, they found their way in. It was under strategy that they tried to again go into those areas where they were in large presence at one point of time. Operation Sarv Vinashak was launched by the army, where a large-scale operation was done to end militancy in these areas. But there are experts which are calling for similar kind of operation in these areas. Now, you will see that there are two sides of a coin. In Kashmir, the forces might have been able to get hold of the situation in terms of the attack on security forces, but in Jammu now the attacks on security forces have been frequent, be it the pilgrims, civilians, the Indian Army. The attempt is to make another front for the Indian Army and the forces to deal with. We already have a hostile neighbor like China on the line of actual control. Then you have the Pakistan in Jammu and Kashmir. So yes, there are three fronts actually, one in Ladakh, one in Kashmir and one in Jammu, and this is the reality that the country is now dealing with. And one has to see that how long does the search operation continue and see for how long will the forces take to neutralize these militants who are hiding in these woods.
All right, Ishan, please stay with us. We're also being joined by News 18's Rajan, who's live with us from Kathua. Rajan, abhi kya halat bane hue hain Kathua mein aur search operation ke bare mein bhi kya jankari mil rahi hai? All right, Rajan, क्या आप हमें सुन सकते हैं?
जी बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, मैं सुन पा रहा हूँ आपको. जी
राजन, क्या हालात बने हुए हैं अभी फिलहाल कठुआ में और सर्च ऑपरेशन के बारे में क्या जानकारी मिल रही
जी,
है?
जी जी बोलें. जी देखिए, मैं इस वक्त उसी स्पॉट पे मौजूद हूँ, ग्राउंड जीरो पे, जहाँ पे ये अटैक हुआ है. जो सामने आप ट्रक देख पा रहे होंगे, उसके जो टायर हैं वहां पे बुलेट्स लगे हुए हैं. इसी सेना के ट्रक पे जो है कल हमला हुआ है. दो ट्रक थे और एक जो है राशन वाला ट्रक था और दूसरा ट्रक जो है वो सामने जो आप देख सकते हैं कुछ ही दूरी पे जो है वो ट्रक लगा हुआ है. तो यही वो स्पॉट है और इस यहाँ पे जिस तरह से हमने टॉपोग्राफी देखी है, इससे साफ हो गया हमें, क्योंकि यहाँ पे जो रास्ता है वो इतना खस्ता है कि यहाँ पे आप 5 या 10 किलोमीटर प्रति आवर से ज्यादा गाड़ी नहीं चला सकते। इसका मतलब कि आतंकवादियों ने यहाँ वैकी की थी, प्लानिंग की थी कि यहाँ से